So let's talk about images. You can add images that will remain static, and you can add dynamic images. So let's start with static images. When you want to add an image to your template, the easiest way is to simply drag and drop the image directly into your template or into the Resources Pane's image folder. Once the image is imported into the Images folder, you can simply drag it directly on the page in order to add it. Images added to your template will retain, by default, their original size. So for instance, this image is a bit larger than the template that we have, and we can resize it. An image, just like any other HTML element, is often relative to its parent. So, for example here, if I resize the image to 100% width, what it does is resizes itself to the body itself, to the space that it has inside of the template. If, on the other hand, you want to resize it to, let's say, 50% of its original size, then you have to basically divide the original width into two and add that as a static size. Images by default are added within the text directly. They don't float around and they're not absolutely positioned. You can't just drag them anywhere onto the page. But because the image is an HTML element, you can basically set it to however you want, just like, for example, boxes. So here I made the box float to the right, so all the text flows around it. You can also add images directly in the middle of your text if the image is, say, small enough. You can also add images directly into any box. So, say you want to add the image rather inside of the header on the top. I'll cut the image here, add a position box. And that adds the image into the box. Now, what about external images? Well, there is a button in the toolbar that is called Insert Image from Address. When you click on that, it'll ask you for the URL of the image. Now, this by default is a static location, so if I just paste the location of an existing online image and I click on Finish, this will add the image directly into my template. Because the image is on the internet, you're dependent on whether the image exists or not, and you're also dependent on whether you have an internet connection. What I mean by this is if you produce print output, and the machine that produces the output doesn't have access to the internet, this image will not work. Also, if the image is deleted from wherever server it's located, you won't have access to it either when you try to produce output. And now it's time to take a look at dynamic images. Dynamic images basically are an image that is variable depending on some data inside of your record. So let's say, for example, that you have a promotion going on, and the promotion is different between Canadian and American customers. Inside of my record set, I have a field called country that is either Canada or US, well, CA or US. What I can do is import images that will be either for CA or US inside of their file name. So what I can do is insert the image inside of my template. And then we can make it dynamic. With the image selected, the easiest way to create a dynamic image wizard is to click on the source link inside of the images attribute. The dynamic image script wizard will basically just show an image depending on a certain field in your data. It works using the prefix and the suffix for the image. So here what I know is that both of my images start with olsg-promo- and then the country code. So I enter this in the prefix, keeping the images folder. And then I use the country field to select the appropriate rest of the image name. The suffix represents the extension for the file. Since both files are JPEG, that works fine. So when we click on OK and we go into preview mode, we'll have a different image depending on if it's a US customer or a CA customer. Now, the thing about dynamic images is that they can actually be anywhere and you can still refer to them as dynamic images. When you click on an image, the source is actually, so the dynamic image source can refer to a dynamic URL, it can refer to an image on the hard drive, or to an image resource inside the template. In order to refer to a file directly on the hard drive, the source needs to be a local path to the hard drive, including the file prefix. So let me add one right here. And this is how it looks. Now, here's a warning. If you use this in a web page or you use this in an email, it will not work because the client does not have access to this file locally on their hard drive. So this would work in print mode if you have resources on a local or shared drive and you can refer to them that way. And if you want to make this dynamic, then you just need to change the prefix inside of your dynamic image script. So that's it for using images inside of the Connect Designer. Now, Planet Press Connect supports multiple types of images. Refer to the documentation to learn a bit more on how to use them.